I want to differentiate really complicated functions. There's a concrete example. Take a look at the function f of x equals 1 plus 2x to the fifth power. Let's try to differentiate this function. We could approach this in a couple different ways. First of all, I could just expand it out. All right, so I'm going to just expand this out. 1 to the fifth is just 1 plus 10x plus 40x squared plus 80x cubed plus 80x to the fourth plus 32x to the fifth. Now it's just a polynomial, so I can fearlessly differentiate it. So f prime of x, if I differentiate this, the derivative of 1 is 0, the derivative of 10x is 10, the derivative of 40x squared is 80x, and then 240x squared, 320x cubed, and 160x to the fourth. Of course, if we're clever at this point, we can also see that this mess factors. So it's sort of believable as a factor of 10 here, since all of these coefficients end in a 0. This is 10 times 1 plus 8x plus 24x squared plus 32x cubed plus 16x to the fourth. What's way less obvious, I mean not obvious at all, is that this mess also factors. It happens to be 1 plus 2x to the fourth power. This is not an accident. What if we instead applied the chain rule to the original problem? So let's compute the derivatives in the chain rule. The first step is going to split up the function f into a composition of two functions, g and h. G here, the outside function, is the fifth power function. And h, the inside function, is 1 plus 2x. So if I combine those two functions, take their composition, I get back f. Now I want to differentiate f. And by the chain rule, that's the derivative of the outside at the inside function times the derivative of the inside function. In this case, what's the derivative of the outside function? The derivative of g is 5x to the fourth. So I'm going to take that but evaluate it at h. 5h of x to the fourth. I'm going to multiply by the derivative of h. What's the derivative of h? Well, it's 2. Whoa, look what I've got here. I've got 5h of x is 1 plus 2x to the fourth times 2. That's 10 times 1 plus 2x to the fourth. That's exactly what we calculated before. It's a really nice example because it shows that we're doing the same calculation. We're calculating the derivative of the function 1 plus 2x to the fifth power, but we're doing it in two different ways. Nevertheless, we get the same answer. Somehow, mathematics is conspiring to be consistent. Okay, well, let's try another example. Well, here's a more complicated function. F of x equals the square root of x squared plus 0.0001. What's the derivative of f? We can't simply expand this function out. And in fact, if you graph the function, you might think that the function's not differentiable because the graph of the function has this sharp corner at the origin. But let's zoom in and see what this actually looks like if we zoom in close enough. If we zoomed in close enough, the thing doesn't look like it has a sharp corner anymore. It actually looks like it's curved. And if we zoomed in even further, the thing would look more and more like a straight line. What we're really seeing is that the function is differentiable. Now we can verify this algebraically. We can use our derivative laws, like the chain rule, to actually calculate the derivative of this function. We'll differentiate this by using the chain rule, since this is really the composition of two functions. It's the composition of the square root function and this polynomial, x squared plus 0.0001. All right, so the derivative of f is the derivative of the outside function, which is the derivative of the square root, which is 1 over 2 square root. And it's the derivative of the outside function evaluated at the inside, which is x squared plus 0.0001. Now I have to multiply by the derivative of the inside function. What's the derivative of x squared plus 0.0001? Well, that's really just the derivative of x squared, since it's a constant, and the derivative of x squared is 2x. So the derivative of f is 1 over 2 times the square root of x squared plus 0.0001 times 2x. I could make that a little bit nicer looking. I could cancel these 2's and write this as x over the square root of x squared plus 0.0001. What happens at 0? So I'm going to compute the derivative at 0. Well, if I plug in 0 for x, I've got 0 over 0 squared plus 0.0001. The denominator is not 0. The numerator is 0. The derivative at 0 is 0. And you can see that from the graph. If I look at when x equals 0, the tangent line at that point is horizontal. The slope of that tangent line is 0. The derivative at 0 is 0. And there's more awesome things that you can see by looking at the derivative. If you look at, say, the limit of the derivative as x approaches infinity, that's the limit of this quantity, which is 1. And the limit of the derivative as x approaches minus infinity is negative 1. And you can see this visibly on the graph of the function. If you plug in a really big number and look at the tangent line there, that tangent line has slope close to 1. And if you plug in a really negative number and look at the tangent line there, that tangent line has slope close to minus 1. Our derivative rules are revealing facts that are hidden. This function looks like it's got a sharp corner, but we know by applying our differentiation rules, by using the chain rule, that this function is in fact differentiable. And we know that if we zoom in close enough, the thing looks like a straight line. The derivative rules are really revealing this structure at very small scales.